The fortress of Meripede is where exiles gather. Sitting on the seabed far beyond the reach of the court of Fontaine, the name alone evokes danger and teeming, breeding chaos. But this fortress, built of bronze and iron, is a bastion of order. One can't help but wonder, who is in charge here? If you have a chance to meet the administrator, you really should go and see for yourself.
You got a side job for me? Sure thing.
No matter how talented a manager you are, it's difficult to convince people in the Fortress of Meripede without the ability to enforce the rules. The intelligent respect the rules, and those who have faced Wriothesley's cryo-gauntlets naturally come to regret their previous ignorance. So as to be ready for anything, Wriothesley makes the most out of any opportunity to prepare. When Wriothesley crafts weapon ascension materials, he has a chance to receive double the product, boosting the party's adventure readiness. Wriothesley's normal attacks condense frost onto his gauntlets, and he strikes rapidly with his repelling fists, dealing cryo damage with a combo of up to 5 swift attacks. Also, for a short time after Wriothesley uses his elemental skill, or sprints, the counter on his normal attack combo will not reset. When using a charged attack, Wriothesley consumes a certain amount of stamina and executes a leaping strike with his vaulting fist, dealing AoE cryo damage. When Wriothesley uses his elemental skill, he quickly adjusts his breathing, rhythm, and pace. Sprinting forward a short distance, he enters the chilling penalty state, increasing his resistance to interruption in order to deliver even more devastating attacks. While in the chilling penalty state, repelling fist is enhanced. Each strike does more damage, but if his HP is above a certain threshold, he loses a small amount of health with each hit in exchange for this power. This effect disappears when Wriothesley leaves the field. After unlocking the talent, there shall be a plea for justice. When Risley's HP is below a certain threshold, he gains Gracious Rebuke, and his next normal attack is enhanced, becoming Rebuke Vaulting Fist. Rebuke Vaulting Fist does not consume stamina, and its damage is increased. After striking a target, Risley regains a portion of his max HP. The Gracious Rebuke effect can only be triggered once in a set period of time.
Have a safe trip!
With his elemental burst, Wriothesley activates his gauntlets, unleashing a ferocious, frosty, straight strike, using icicle impact on the area in front of him to deal multiple instances of AoE cryo damage. After icicle impact ends, a surging blade falls on the opponent's position, dealing Usea-aligned cryo damage. Behind every crime lies an action, and those actions have consequences. After unlocking the talent, there shall be a reckoning for sin. When Risley's HP increases or decreases, if he is in the chilling penalty state after using his elemental skill, chilling penalty will gain a stack of prosecution edict, increasing his attack. This effect can stack up to a certain limit. It's a good idea to avoid unnecessary battles, but for Wriothesley, turning the tables on someone and throwing down can be quite the cool and refreshing experience. In battle, Wriothesley quickly primes himself for the fight by using his elemental skill, before unleashing his repelling fist to attack. The HP lost at this time is exactly what he needs to enhance his charged attacks. In harmony with his own battle rhythm, Wriothesley can unleash an even more powerful Rebuke Vaulting Fist, dealing a powerful blow to enemies while regaining composure. When his energy is full, Wriothesley can punch forward with Condensed Frost, dealing multiple instances of AoE cryo damage to punish mischief makers and rabble rousers. Human lives are short, and their memories cannot be passed on. The origins of the Fortress of Meripede have long become shrouded in the mists of the past, and difficult to verify. But as the prophesized catastrophe looms ever closer, Wriothesley pieced together the lost shards of history and revealed once more the silent secrets of the underwater fortress. The condemned willingly serve the gods out of their own sense of guilt, but have they ever considered that the gods may be unable to bring them the consolation they need?